Shampoo Road. That's Dr. Cheese. And I'm Price. I got chips in my mouth. We got a shirtless edition of Shampoo Road. It's hot out, man. I'm not putting on the AC and wasting money yet. And I'm not putting on a shirt because I hate the winter. I like to be free. Anyway, I'm going to show some of my books today. Let's start off. I'm going to have to make a mess, man. I got them all just stacked on the wall in my room. I'm going to have to like rip them out and throw them all over the place and pick it up later. I'm going to start and finish with the best books ever. The greatest book of all time. My girlfriend got me this. The Bible. I just started reading the Bible like a year ago, dude. When I first woke up, I got into like all the spirituality stuff. And there's a lot of good self-help there. But I think there's a lot of dead ends. And there's not a lot of praising the creator, you know. I mean, I found a lot of good self-help stuff in these spiritual books I have. But I, honestly, when I started reading the Bible, something slapped me, man. Something really hit me. And I had some good friends that showed me stuff. I was lost. I didn't know where to look for stuff, you know. Dude, the Bible's there, man. God loves you. And that's his word. And I don't care how silly that sounds. I'm laughing at myself. I used to be a freaking metalhead anyway. Let's check out some of my books here. No appropriate order. We got Super Memory. It's another good brain book here. Real brain buster. Lynn McTaggart, The Field. This is about like, you know, like kind of like the ether. The invisible force that controls everything. And this is, you know, a good book. Tony Robbins, man. This is when I got out of jail, dude. I read this. This changed my life. And, you know, got me going. There's a lot of good self-help stuff in here, man. A lot of self-confidence. Good stuff. Got Dr. David Hawkins. I got a bunch by him. Truth versus Falsehood. That's a great one. Transcending the Levels of Consciousness. My girlfriend's reading Power versus Force right now. I'll let her borrow that. Got the Entrepreneur's Toolbook right here. It's a good one if you want to, you know, run your own business, learn all that jazz. The Secret Teachings of All Ages. This is like a Freemason kind of book. And there's a lot of real deep spiritual stuff in here and a lot of weird stuff and I don't know, I could talk about this for a while, but anyway, let's keep going. Got some basic astrology. We got this. I like David Icke, man. Some people think he's a weirdo, but he's a good dude, and he points out a lot of weird deception. And I got another book by him about the reptilians, man. I'll get to the reptilians. Creepy, weird stuff. Got the Gene Keys. This is a good one. This is all about your DNA and the Chinese hexagram and how, like, your DNA is like connected to all your emotions and like there's like opposites and that's another I'm not good at explaining some stuff, man. I'm not that pro. Some of this is like too complicated to like try to explain, but you just gotta read it, you know. We got some looking some of that stuff. This is one of the first books I got when I kind of woke up. I went into Savers. It's like a thrift shop here in Connecticut, and I used to only read Stephen King. It's like all I cared about, just horror and boobs and blood and blah blah blah. And something led me to the spirituality and religion section for some reason. And this just stuck out. And, you know, there's a lot of good stuff in here. I don't really believe, you know, follow a lot of it now that I read the Bible. But a lot of good, helpful stuff in here. Here's another good one. Autobiography of a Yogi. This is a magical book right here. The story of this dude's life is amazing. He brought yoga to America. And he talks about, like, meeting all these different yogis and, like, guys that could levitate. People that are breatharians, people that could just live on breathing air and the prana forever. Pretty cool stuff. I guess Steve Jobs gave this to every single one of his employees. What else we got here? It's all about death, you know, like, not like in a mean way, but like, you know, how it affects people and how it affects you and psychic development. Now, I don't really, you know, it's good to have psychic abilities, but like reading people's palms and doing all that divination, using it for evil, that's bad stuff. But it's good to know, like, when you clean your brain up, like, God gave you psychic abilities. Like, you're supposed to feel people's emotions, and you know what I mean? Like, it's good to know. David Wilcock, this guy may or may not be a shill, but synchronicity is kind of a cool thing. He talks about I got a piece of chip in my mouth. He talks about, like, the hero's journey and, like, how it applies to your life. And when you start doing good stuff and raising your vibration, you see synchronicities. You see repeating signs and symbols. And this is kind of another good book here. Chakra Bible. Good to know. You know what I mean? Like, you got chakras, all your energy centers. It's good to know what they're all about. I don't really believe in the whole crystal thing anymore. I think it's kind of a rouge. But crystals are powerful. And I don't really fuck with them anymore, you know? There's a lot of stuff I got into when I first woke up that, you know, I don't really. This one's just like, I got all my fiction and nonfiction. This snuck its way in here. I love X-Files. Mulder's hilarious. Ninja mind control. There's a lot of good mantras in here. Or not mantras. What are those things? Mudras. The hand fucking things. Yeah. I'm still learning about that too. Energy Speaks. This is a channeled book. I got a couple of channeled books here. Part 2, Energy Speaks. It's a channeled book. Channeled books are when someone... you kind of like meditate into a state of like... when you can like channel a spirit voice through you. Or like get knowledge from the other side. And kind of creepy stuff. It's kind of interesting to learn though, you know? What else we got here? We got a little book of psychology here. I mean, I learned a bunch from this book. It's so simple. It goes over case studies of psychology. And like, you know, once you learn more about psychology... you learn how your brain works, and you learn how other people's works, and you learn how to, like, interact with yourself and others. Good stuff. The Gift. Here's a good one. Gary Zukav, Soul Stories. I got another one by him. It's pretty good. It talks about, like, the journey of the soul and all the different steps it takes and, like, you know, where your soul comes from, where it goes, what it evolves into. Butterfly Effect. There's a good one. This is just a fun picture book. It's, you know, what the Butterfly Effect's about. The Bhagavad Gita, dude, I got into this before I got into the Bible. It's good stuff, but I think there's a lot of idol worship in here, and you know, be careful. There's another one, Tony Robbins, man. I'm not a big fan of money, but you need it, and this dude's a pretty, you know, he's a whiz, man. He's a smart guy, and he seems really pleasant. It's hard to think some of these good people are, like, you know, with the Illuminati. Astral projection. Another thing, good to know, but it's another thing, like the psychic stuff, it's good to know, it's good to utilize, but don't over fuck with it and, you know, make it like your thing. Like, you're supposed to be here on this planet. You don't want to leave your body too much because you're supposed to learn lessons here on Earth. Communist Manifesto, good to know. This is what's going on in the world right now. You got to read about, like, where it originally got started and what people were thinking back then, because it's coming to fruition now, man. You got to prepare for this stuff. It's looking creepy. The Presidents and UFOs. Yeah. I don't know. Do I need to say more? Here we go. Walden and Civil Disobedience. Here's a good smart one from back in the day. A lot of these, some of them I haven't even read. I just know what they're about. I probably read like a third of my books. The Power of Now. Eckhart Tolle. Here's another good one. Good spiritual. Kind of like the Law of Attraction. Just realize that now is the only time that matters, man. Supposedly, like, everything's happening now. We just can't tell because, you know, like, time is an illusion and we're here and, you know, past, present, future is all right now. The only time you have power is right now. You know what I mean? You can't dwell on the past and you can't worry about the future. Now is the time to get stuff done. We got another one by Eckhart Tolle. I don't know. I've heard him talk before. I think he's faking his voice. Like, he sounds like some wise professor with the crusty voice. I like him. I like his stuff. But, you know, some of these, like, real big guys, you got to question it, man. You gotta question everything. What else we got here? Freaking. Me and my girlfriend love plants. She's better, you know, than I am. With little bonsai trees. It's fun, man. Bonsai trees are beautiful. Reiki. Uh-oh. You know, more of that, you know, spiritual healy stuff. But I'm telling you, you gotta be careful with this stuff. It's good to read. It's good to know. But don't overutilize this stuff. The Dictionary of Dreams. All right. You know what dreams are? No, I don't either. But I'm pretty sure when you die or when you go to the next level... you're in where you go when you dream. So you got to do real good stuff while you're here. So you have a real good eternal dream. Because I think hell is an eternal nightmare. You do real bad shit here and that's just going to build up and manifest. And that's where you're going to be stuck with. You're going to be stuck in pain. Like, you ever have a dream and it feels real? It's because it kind of is real. You know what I mean? Kundalini yoga. Yoga's good. Yoga makes your body feel good. 7 Habits of Highly Effective Teens. This is one I had when I was younger. I've been messing up since I was a kid, man. I didn't clean my shit up till like 5 years ago. Look how beat this thing is. Utilized. Stephen Hawking, A Brief History in Time. Good to know. Good, a lot of this I don't agree with anymore now that I think the earth is flat, but, you know. I question whether he is even what he says he is with this handicap. This Age of Spiritual Machines. This is written by Ray Kurzweil. He's like the executive of Google. He's talking about when AI takes over. And this book was written like 20-something years ago. It's all coming to fruition again, man. This guy knows what's up. He's probably a fucking Freemason, you know. But good stuff. He's talking about when AI gets as smart as humans. And bad news, man. I don't know about that. I'm not digging it. What else we got here? covert hypnosis. This is like an actual manual from like a college. Another thing, like, don't use it for evil, man. Don't use it for evil. You can like sway someone's opinion in a good way by like being smart, but don't like take advantage of them. Like, this is good to know. It's also good to know so you don't get taken advantage of. Like, a lot of these books are so you can protect yourself, not like take advantage of other people. I got books on meditation. I got a bunch of books on meditation. Zachariah Sitchin, dude, this one's cool. He supposedly transcribed the Sumerian tablets, and it talks about the Anunnaki and like where we come from and like the alien creators. And I don't know if I believe in this too much anymore, but it's pretty good. A lot of this stuff, when I started reading the Bible, like, it just slaps. The Bible slaps everything, man. Another Zachariah Sitchin book, End of Days. I think we're in the end of days right now, huh? Peak Performance Principles for High Achievers. I don't even have to explain that there. There's another, you know, good. There's little quotes in here that are meaningful, you know. There's some pleasant stuff in there. The Power of Your Subconscious Mind. I don't have to explain that one. The Tao of Physics. Here's another good one. It explains like how spirituality and mathematics kind of meet halfway, and, you know, pretty smart stuff. Here's a great one. The Hidden Messages in Water. Water holds energy. Water holds information. When you talk to it and say nice things to it, it crystallizes like a snowflake there. It makes beautiful designs. When you say mean stuff to it or play bad music or yell at it, it just turns all bubbly and gross. It's nasty. It's just powerful stuff, man. Here we go. George Orwell's 1984. Yeah, I don't have to say more about that, man. We know where we're going with that. Stages of the Soul is another good one about your soul, what you're doing here, yada yada. Got the stars and the planets. Good to know. Even though I don't think they are what they say they are, if you zoom in on a star or a planet with your phone, it's some crazy electrical ball of energy. It's not something that's that far away, you know what I mean? The sun's not 93 million miles away, dude. It's like right there. It's fucking obvious. Breakthrough to Deception. Easy Journey to Other Planets, another spiritual, you know, weird one. What we got here? I got a bunch here. I'm just trying to pick through. I got some dumb ones. Marcus Aurelius Meditations. We got some wise stuff out of this dude. Another book about meditation. Allegory of the Cave by Plato. Here's a good one. From back in the day. Some of these, I don't think they were written back when they were, but hey, what's up? I'm making a video. Say hi.
Hi.
I never read this one. I don't know what it's about. It was just in my pile. Here's some more Plato. Socrates. The Conscious Universe. Here's a good one. The Tao of Health section, Longevity. This is a good one about your health and, you know, stuff you should be eating, what food does inside you, different combinations of food and how they hurt you. This one's just a happy one. My grandma passed away and I found this in a garage. And it makes me happy. Becoming Supernatural by Joe Dispenza. Here's a good one about your pineal gland and how to activate it and what it really does. Your Sixth Sense, another one about your psychic abilities. The Good Dad, here's a good one. This is a good, pleasant one. Way of the Peaceful Warrior. Whoop. Here's another good one. I think it's a not real story about something that's good, and I only read part of it, but everyone says it's good. Unlimited Power by Tony Robbins. Here's a good one about, you know, utilizing your power. Toxic Deception. This one's all about how America's gross and greedy, and I don't even really need to explain more. Aha, here we go. Here's a great one. Children of the Matrix. This one's crazy. It shows where Satanism is like everywhere in this country. And supposedly like reptilians are like in our world leaders and they're shape-shifting and all sorts of crazy stuff. This book is banned in jails. Like, they don't want you reading this book in jail for some reason. I got it. I love this book. It's so weird and cool. Under an Ionized Sky. Here's a book all about chemtrails. I had to go and get this. I had to know more about all the weird chemicals and what they're actually doing. Spraying these stratospheric aerosols into the air and doing all sorts of weird stuff with weather modification. Atlantis, good to know. Good to know. I haven't read a lot of these, man. Yeah, I don't even know what this one's about. I didn't read it yet. Machu Kaku Visions. It's that dude on the History Channel. I think he's full of shit, but you know what I mean? This is an interesting read. Man, I got a lot of books, huh? Whoa, what's over here? Classic Mythology. This is always good to know, man. Nostradamus. Here we go. The prophet of all times, man. He's predicting what's going on. I can't talk today. Fun with hieroglyphics. This is a stamp kit I had when I was a kid. Treasure Island. I don't know how that got in here. This is supposed to be my nonfiction pile. I don't know what the hell that is. Yeah. Here's your boy, Bill Gates. The speed of thought. What a dork. Look at this dickweed. Ass clown. Maya Cosmogenesis. This is really good. This dude studied this stuff a lot. You know, what's this? George Washington. This is a kid's book. I just wanted to like cut it up. All right. When I first woke up and got into spirituality, I thought magic was kind of a good thing. But I got this book. Beware. This is deception right here. This dude, he went West Memphis 3. Him and his friends supposedly killed some kids over some Saint ritual back in the day. And they got in jail. And then... Then Johnny Depp and Eddie Vedder befriended them. And he said he manifested his escape from jail. Not escape, his freedom from jail by using magic. And that's just sketchy. Like, what's Johnny Depp and Eddie Vedder doing befriending someone in jail for child sacrifice? Like, even if he was innocent, that's freaking weird. What are you doing? I don't think he's innocent. I think those guys helped him get out of jail because they like to do the same stuff. Here's another book of deception right here. Path of Shadow by Morg. This guy's a fucking clown. He's really smart, but he's like really deceptive. He hates Christianity. It's all about like loving yourself. He made up some own religion called Hyperionism. It's just weird. And he said he knows stuff about ontological math, and he never really even like proves any of the stuff he's talking about. I think he's all just like running his fucking mouth. He's like a sword swallower, fucking weirdo. The Secret. This is like Law of Attraction for Dummies. I don't know what this is. I haven't read it yet. I got a lot of books. More from the Bhagavad Gita. Again, more of the Bhagavad Gita. Interesting, but, you know, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. What are those ones? Book of Secrets. More like Hindu mysticism. Seat of the Soul by Gary Zukav. This one's amazing. This one's really cool and interesting. And, like, again, it's like about your soul's journey. What's this? Awakening the Mind. There's another good one about meditating and like utilizing your brain waves and like frequencies from it. Smart stuff. Healing Mantras. Hey, this stuff's kind of cool. All About That Time Travel. This is cool. Another hard copy of Autobiography of a Yogi. I love Corey Feldman, so I had to read his book. It's so cool. It's such a cool story, man. He's my favorite actor. I'm not idolizing him at all, but I don't know. He calls out pedophiles and, you know, all that weird stuff in Hollywood. And I think he might be a good dude. I mean, he hangs out with Michael Jackson in here, says a bunch of weird stories. Good, fun book, man. Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This is a great one. You want to utilize your brain power and learn how to, you know, put your brain power to the test. And, you know, you don't really have to use this to make money, but you use it to utilize your power. I Ching and Business and Decision Making. Law of Attraction, this is a channeled work. This guy and his wife, he helped her go into like a hypnotic state, and like she just started like talking, and she said she was talking from the voice of this guy named Abraham, who's like a different dimensional entity, and it just says like all about life. It's like, this thing reads like stereo instructions. I know, I got that from Beetlejuice. It's like a manual of like how to do things right, kind of. It's smart stuff, but creepy how they got that information, you know? I got another one of those. Law of Attraction and Money. The Vortex, and the Law of Attraction and Relationships. The New Human, this is kind of like Reiki. I got a couple more. This is just a weird smart book, I don't know. Tai Chi. Kundalini Yoga. Psychic Abilities. NSYNC. And now, back to the Bible, back to the greatest book of all time. My friend Tom got me this one. It's a cute little red leather one. Feels so nice in the hand. Red letters of Jesus in there. I got an English Standard Bible. I got another Bible. I just got this one. This is a 1611. It's like an original print kind of looking thing with the old-timey words, and it's got the Apocrypha in it, all the books they took out. Oh, I thought I had another. Illumination. This is another, like, good book about, like, you know, Christ's spirituality. Of Course in Miracles. Book of Common Prayers. And this last one, I just got a huge Apocrypha collection. This is like a whole bunch of removed books from the Bible. Like a whole bunch of good stuff. The Book of Enoch, all that. Man, I gotta pick up all these books. I just threw them all over the place to show you. I hope you enjoyed that, man. Come down to Shampoo Road and snack down. I got some books to read, huh? I gotta bone up on some of these. I only read like a third or a fourth of them, but go check some of them out. Some of them are better than the others. Some of them you gotta watch out for. You know what I mean? There's deception everywhere. So enjoy, snack down, have a good weekend. Shampoo Road. Got a wet mullet.